The new Sweet Handling Mustang 2s are more Mustang than ever.
Hey, Moto Exotica fans, welcome to this week's Motocast. Today we're going to talk about this righteous 1977 Mustang 2 Cobra 2. Mustang's been around since 1965. This is basically the second generation of Mustang. Mustang 2s are probably most famous to hot rodders for their front end. Mustang went to a rack and pinion steering, and so it's a lot tighter and precise, and you'll find them under countless hot rods today. So while 1977 was the second to last year of the Cobra 2, 78 was the last, and that is when the King Cobra came available. I believe Farrah Fawcett drove one in Charlie's Angels, made famous by Farrah Fawcett and that beautiful smile. I believe it was white with a blue and white Cobra on the hood. So Ford was trying to keep up with Pontiac with the onslaught of Burt Reynolds' Crazy Chicken on top of that Trans Am, right? So it was a change of times. We had the oil embargo, and so the Mustang 2 was kind of an answer to that. So when the Mustang 2 first came out, it was a hit. It was a success. People were looking for a smaller iteration of the Mustang that had got bigger over the years. In fact, it was Motor Trend's Car of the Year in 1974. That was quite a distinction. That did not happen again until 1994. So there was 20 years in between Mustang getting it right. Okay, so under the hood of this Mustang Cobra 2 beast, tried and true Ford 302. Now this one has been massaged. It has a, under here, we've got a Street Dominator high-rise, or at least for the era, high-rise intake manifold. And we got a Garrett supercharger. So superchargers were just coming out during that era. This is a single-stage turbocharger. I don't know exactly how much more turbo the horsepower adds, but it is considerably more than the anemic 302 was tuned for in its original form. So here's something else that was very 70s, and that is T-tops, right? They had them in the Camaros, they had them in the Trans Ams. Of course, Mustang 2 had to have them as well, so pretty cool. Factory sunroofs came right out. There was plenty of aftermarket companies that did them as well. Of course, they were known to leak. The other thing that became very popular in the 70s was sunroofs. So you could take them to a chop shop, they cut a hole in the roof, put in a pop-up sunroof. This one has got factory T-tops, so very nice. Even got the factory louvers on here. Okay, so inside of this Cobra 2, it's feeling like a sports car, it really is. It's got a nice three-spoke wheel in it. It's got a four-speed, which everything back then was really pretty much an automatic, so the Cobra 2 came with a four-speed. And with the addition of the Garrett turbo under the hood, one of the previous owners, we're not quite sure who, chose to put in some additional gauges, some Smith Warner gauges that'll give you your turbo boost, your fuel pressure, water temperature, and oil temperature as well. It was fairly Spartan in the dash as well. We also have the addition of vacuum. So right here you'll find turbo boost that you can dial in and up, which is also old school. Everything today is, of course, digital. This was very analog. So you can increase your turbo boost here by simple twist of the knob, and pretty cool. So you can play with it, get a little more horsepower out of your car, and beat most anybody out there, because nobody had a real 500 horsepower car. We're thinking horsepower on this car now might be about 220, something like that. These cars today are not bought for speed. They're kind of bought for their panache, their looks. And really, there weren't a whole lot of black Cobras out there in the day. So this one being very nice and original, nice original T-tops, nice original seats and interior. Carpet's real nice. It's ready to go. And it comes complete with A-Track. So here's another unique feature on this Mustang 2. And that is that it was a three-door or hatchback, right? There were other, the early iterations of the Mustang did have a fastback, and they did have a fold-down seat, but they only had a trunk. So now with the addition, which, okay, the only way to get in here, it didn't have a front release, it didn't have a popper. You had to old school use the round key, not the square key, to get into the trunk, right? Lift it up, And now all of a sudden you could turn your Mustang II into a pickup truck. Gave you a lot of room, very spacious. You could go on trips. Look at all that space. So this was unique for the times as well. Thanks for watching this edition of our Motocast. We always have something unique and different, not just shoes. But if you want something different by today's standard, come get this Mustang II Cobra. You'll have the only one on the block. And better yet, it's turbocharged.